Hello, Didier Stevens here with the fifth video on my new tool, DNS Resolver, and this time we are going to surf files over DNS. So let's look at the man page. Okay, so you have a payload command that allows you to surf files over DNS records, TXT or null records. You have to provide a file with the content that you want to surf, or you can also provide the data via the command line that you want to surf. If you use data, then you have to provide a label. If you use file, you can provide a label, but it's not mandatory. If there is no label, then the file name without the extension will be used as a label. And then there are different encodings that you can apply. So encoding on the records that are being served, the DNS records, the content of them, or data encoding for the data that you provide through the command line. So let's start serving an ICAR file. This is the ICAR file, and I'm going to serve this over DNS. So it's a payload, and the file is ICAR.vir. That's it. Now this is being served. And if here I do a lookup for ICAR. I did not provide a label, so the label is the name of the file without the extension, so that's ICAR. Yeah. I'm going to request a TXT record, so ICAR example.com, and through the local machine here, and then you can see in the text record here the ICAR string. Here you can see the output of DNS Resolver. And that's a way you can serve a file. Now, over DNS text records, there's not that much data that you can serve. They are around 500 bytes large. I limit the size of a string in the TXT record to maximum 250 bytes. So with my tool, you can serve at most 500 bytes via UDP TXT record. So let's do this for a larger file. I did copy here, for example, write. A small executable, 11K. So we are going to be serving this. So the file is write.exe, and this time I'm going to provide a label, and I'm going to use the label surf like this, and now if I do a request for surf, not server, like this, here you can see two strings, the start of an PE file, MZ. Now the complete start of the file has been shared, but there is a problem. There are null bytes in here, and NSLOOKUP cannot properly represent those null bytes. So if you look at Wireshark, here I have Wireshark running. So here I have my response for ICAR. So here you have a byte here that indicates de lengte of de string. And here you have the string itself. And now let's go take a look for surf examples. So the eikar. Here you can see the length is 250, 250. And here you actually have the complete start of the PE file for D5A90, but then there's a zero, and that's why the string here is not displayed, as well in Wireshark, as here with NSLOOKUP. So what you can do, if you wanted, is say to my DNS resolver tool that it has to encode the data before it is put in a TXT or a null record. And it's quite simple. You say just encoding, let's say hex. So you can say hex, base64 or dynamic. And now, when we do exactly the same request, here you can see you have an hexadecimal answer. You see here for D5A9000 and so on. Now, these two strings of 250 bytes, hexadecimal digits actually. So that's the first part of the file. If you want the next part, you have to use an index. The next part is one. So here I did request surfexample.com, but I can also do surf0example.com. That's exactly the same. I get the first part. And then I can do one, and I get the next part, and so on. And then, when you arrive at the last part, I think 44 here. Yeah, 44, all zeros. 45, yeah. That's almost the end of the file. If you do a 46, then you get an NX domain, an R code. Three, that's your return. So that's how you know that the complete file has been served. Of course, I'm doing this here with NSLOOKUP as a demonstration, but this is something that can be script in VBA or in PowerShell, for example, to automate its complete download. If I select base64, the file here is saved as base64, so you will need less records. And you can also make it dynamic. Dynamic, that means that the client decides which encoding is to be provided. So if you do it like this, serve zero, you get the raw unencoded data. If you say here hex, then you get hexadecimal, and here if you say base64, then you get base64. And you see this is the typical base64 start for a PE file, an MZ header. Now, these are, of course, if you want to transfer large files, this will take quite some time. Now, if you look at the help of DNS Resolver, there's also a TCP option. If I enable that TCP option, and let me say that I'm going to do again base64. Well, no. Let's do hexadecimal encoding. TCP. Now, DNS Resolver is not only listening on UDP port, but also on a TCP port, so 53. And if I do a request like this, I get a lot of output. The thing that is happening, so the request comes in, and then a UDP request, and then my DNS resolver answer this time with, again, the TXT record, but it also said that the content is truncated, the truncated flag is set. And It does this only when you use the option TCP, because a client that then also support communication over TCP will see the TCP, sorry, the truncate flag, and then it will do the request again, but over TCP. And over TCP, you get around 64K that can be transferred. So that's a much more data that can be transferred. And I can show you that. So I'm going to do the request again. I'm going to use my RE search command to extract the hexadecimal code. So it's between double quoted strings, so I'm going to extract this. So here I have complete hexadecimal strings. Now I'm going to convert this hexadecimal to binary. And I'm going to calculate the hash. So this is the hashes. These are the hashes of the file that was served over a single DNS record over TCP. And if I calculate the hash, you can see that they are identical. Now, this was serving of files. You can also serve larger files. For example, I have here also a notepad that will require, well, let's do that. Let's just do this. Base 64. Notepad. Again with the TCP option. I use the same label, surf. So this is the first part, base64 encoded. Second part. Third part. Fourth part. This indicates that we're already reaching some zeros. Fifth part, and here we are already at the end. So, sorry, sixth part here. So here we're already at the end. Now that was serving of files that are on disk. Via data, you can also serve content that you provide through the command line. So payload, sorry, type is payload. The label, I'm going to say, well, fileless. Data. This is a test. Let's serve this. Do a request for fileless. And here you see the file that is, as well, the content that is being served. You could also serve, for example, the ICAR file like this, because the ICAR string is pure ASCII. So I could say something like this. Ask again for the ICAR string. Then I get the ICAR string. The data that you provide here via the command line, you can also encode this hexadecimal basic or base64. So that it is not how the data will be served, but how the data is provided through the command line. So I'm going to type 41, 42, 43, 44 in hexadecimal. So that's uppercase letter A, B, C, D. And so I say that the data encoding is hex, like this. And now if I ask for iCar, well, it's actually not an iCar, but okay. I kept the label iCar. Then you can see here ABCD.